Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Minnesota has a rich and storied history in college football, and the Gophers are at home today. A sparkling stadium is their venue, the most luxurious Gopher hole you can imagine, and they are hoping that they can bury their visitors. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Of the University of Minnesota for some college football action. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Minnesota is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Scrambling around. He's at midfield, and down he goes at the 50.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
From midfield, first down. Got some open field. He's tackled around the 36-yard line. So the run goes for a big first down.
The offensive line opened up some nice lanes to run through as well. Nice play.
Fires incomplete. He was looking for the tight end.
Sometimes when you throw it that hard, you can't control the accuracy all that well. He'll get it under control, though, in time.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 36. Looks middle. Got his back. Tackle at the 26.
Call it a gain of 10 yards. Third down.
And they make the stop at the 15-yard line. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
From the 15-yard line, it's first down. And they'll get him in the backfield.
You're not going to see this very often from this running back. He just got gobbled up pretty deep in the backfield.
Left and he'll lose yards here. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Fires quick out to the receiver and he can't make the grab.
The pass was right on target, so that took a perfectly timed hard hit to knock it free. Strong defense to deny the completion.
He heaves it to the end zone.
Big stop by the defense. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
That makes it 2nd and 8.
Jackson, Oklahoma.
Give to the tailback, and he's met in the backfield.
That's a loss of 3 yards. That brings up 3rd and 12.
Third and 12. Ball on the 18-yard line. Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run. King to punt. Raymond fields it at the 46. They'll bring him down at the 36-yard line. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Dumps it complete over the middle. And he's tackled at the 27.
Smith the tackle at the 27-yard line. That makes it 2nd and 2.
So it's 2nd down and about 2 yards to go. They'll bring him down at about the 27-yard line. It out maybe to the 26-yard line. From the 26-yard line, first down. And he just gets rid of it. Positive yardage.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Third down again.
Man left.
Let's see if the third time's a charm down here in the red zone. He's scrambling. And he's sacked.
He has one job on passing situations. Get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
We've played one quarter. Still no score. Ready for more football here in quarter number 2. He caught it, but they're not going to get it. He's tackled immediately. The defense holds, and the ball will change hands. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Up the middle for a nice game.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
It's third and seven. Ball in the 23. Now he's scrambling, and he tackles him hard at the 17.
That'll bring up fourth and 13.
King is the punter. Raymond fields it at the 46. Tackle at the 46-yard line. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Tries to buy some time, and they get the sack. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 46. Got it to the sophomore. He gets hit out of bounds around the 30-yard line.
16 yards. First down.
From the 25-yard line, second down. And he is drilled at the 28. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20. Draw here. Brought down right around the 12-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
The red zone has not been kind to this offense. Are they going to end this drought? They work the right side, and there is nothing going there. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
Colorado just took their first time out. And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half. Taken down at the 15. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. It's fourth down.
They'll line it up for the field goal. Colorado is looking to go up by three. Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights. Gray has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Oh, man, he took him down hard. Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he's taken down at the 45-yard line. With room to run. And down he goes at the 44-yard line. From the 44-yard line, first down. Throws it in a hurry. He's tackled right around the 32-yard line. Around the 29-yard line. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 29. Quick throw out to the receiver. So the pass is complete for an 8-yard gain and a first down.
This quarterback still hasn't missed a receiver on this drive.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Checking in once again on what's going on in Jonesboro. And for Navy, we might have an upset percolating in this one. Arkansas State leads it 14-10.
People were predicting some upsets this week, but I'd be shocked if that score holds up. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Fielded at the 9. He's out to the 30, and down he goes at the 35-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Colorado's going to have to use their second timeout of the half. From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle at the 40-yard line. Caught, and big hit there to stop it. They couldn't get the first down.
Well, here they were hoping to get a few extra yards after the catch. Give the defense credit. They held him short.
Cole, the return man. He's tackled at the 28-yard line. The Golden Gophers, over the years, have had great quarterbacks. They've got another one. He's proving to be that here in the first half, and he's the true leader of this group right now.
Leadership. You hit the nail right on the head. This team is moving the football, but it has everything to do with this young man and what he's been able to do for them. Because, he's making great throws. He's making good checks at the line of scrimmage. But the thing that's standing out to me is his leadership and the way this team responds to that leadership. And that's why this team right now has played as well as they have.
Minnesota is up by four. Scrambling around. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. Defensive dominance through two quarters of play. We go to halftime. The Golden Gophers in front, 7-3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow. Just a one possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is. And it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, like a game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later.
Yeah.
We loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Are they stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. They're set to go for another round.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home.
Minnesota is up four. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they make the stop, the 42-yard line. It out to about the 50. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. Fights forward to about the 46.
Gain of one on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Mike 51, Mike 51.
They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. And he's tackled at the 41. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, trying to kick it out of bounds. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He scrambled. They'll make the sack.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
from their own 18-yard line. It's second down. Running back picked up about 8 on the draw.
Third down.
Steps out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. Tries to get around the corner. Cole fields at the 48, and he's tackled at the 45. The Buffaloes have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Minnesota holds a 4-point lead. Sapp. On the inside handoff, they'll bring him down at the 46.
Loss of one on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
From the 46-yard line, second down. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He's knocked out of bounds at the 40.
Well-designed route and a confidently thrown football by the quarterback. You need those things to make any offense work.
He's on the run. Tackle made around the 26-yard line. Gains his way to the 16-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 13-yard line. From the 13-yard line, it's first down. Gets to about the 11-yard line. Minnesota is up by 4. He makes it to the 9. On the draw.
That'll make it fourth and 2.
Fourth down. This should be an easy field goal. Kicks away, and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Fielded at the 9. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Minnesota's coaching staff will go out tonight. I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Ready?
Caught, and he's hit immediately.
Second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 27.
I got 40.
Now he's scrambling. He's to the 40. Brought down around the 45-yard line. We're headed to the fourth quarter, and both of these defenses are still stealing the show. Minnesota leads it 10-3. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. He's taken down around the 46-yard line. In second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Gets out to around the 38.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. First down.
Strike to his receiver, no good.
These guys just don't seem to be on the same page, and they're going to have to be if they expect to win this game.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 38. He's scrambling, and he's taken down around the 37-yard line. Got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Throws complete, but it's not going to be enough. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Minnesota is up 7. Now he tries to buy some time. Try and scramble. And down he goes. That's the 39.
Gain of 5 yards. That makes it 3-3.
Larry, Larry, Larry. Let's go, let's go. Hey, we got Mike, number 7. Blue 19. Blue 19. Check, 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 check. Hey.
Positive yardage. So the option keeper will get him a first down.
It's a very well executed option play. The blocking was there. The quarterback made the correct decision to keep it himself and get the first down.
And a quick throw. He's tackled right around midfield.
First down. Well, that's a strong run. It makes a statement when you can run the ball like that.
First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Just under two to go in the game. Gets to about the 41-yard line. The running back gets two on the carry.
The sophomore just stuck it to the ball carrier right there. That's a very good tackle.
He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
Woo! I think everybody in the stadium felt that hit. He really laid some lumber there.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Scrambling around. Dives, and he's down. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31. They'll run it. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That makes it second and six.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
Two ties. Three down. Mike 51.
Down. Blue 19. Cut.
Makes it out to about the 16. From the 16-yard line. First down. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee. And that should do it. Our final tally of this one. 10-3, Minnesota. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.